Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the second lecture of electrical power transmission course. In this lecture, I am going to discuss the EHVAC and UHVAC transmission lines with their statistics around the world, including Pakistan. EHVAC stands for Extra High Voltage Alternating Current Transmission Line. It can be defined as a transmission line operating above 220 kV is known as Extra High Voltage AC Transmission Line. Now question may arise that how many extra high voltage AC transmission lines are operating in Pakistan? The answer to this question is that at present 16 extra high voltage AC transmission lines are operating in Pakistan. It is because Pakistan has 16 500 kV transmission lines which are above 220 kV. The list of all 16 extra high voltage transmission lines with their location and capacities are shown in the table. Similarly, UHVAC stands for Ultra High Voltage AC Transmission Line. It can be defined as a transmission line operating above 765 kV is known as Ultra High Voltage AC Transmission Line. Now again, question may arise that how many Ultra High Voltage AC transmission lines are operating in Pakistan? The answer to this question is that at present, Pakistan don't have any Ultra High Voltage AC transmission line. This slide shows the highest AC transmission voltage operating in the world, including Pakistan. At present, China is the only country which transmits the power at highest AC transmission voltage of 1000 kV. China is the leader in ultra-high voltage transmission lines all over the world. At present, several ultra-high voltage transmission lines are operating in China. Except China, every country in the world has maximum 765 kV for transmitting the electrical power. The highest AC transmission voltage operating in USA and India is 765 kV. It may be noted that in Madhya Pradesh, there is 1 km transmission line which transmits the power at 1200 kV. However, this line is under testing condition in India. This is world's highest transmitting voltage. The highest AC transmission voltage in Pakistan and Malaysia is 500 kV. This slide shows the highest DC transmission voltage operating in the world, including Pakistan. At present, China has the highest operating voltage of plus minus 1100 kV HVDC transmission line in the world. Brazil and India are operating their HVDC transmission lines at plus minus 800 kV. USA is operating its HVDC transmission line at plus minus 500 to 600 kV. At present, Pakistan don't have any HVDC transmission line. However, in future, two HVDC transmission lines are going to be installed. One plus minus 660 kV HVDC transmission line from Matiari to Lahore through China Pakistan Economic Corridor CPEC project. Two plus minus 500 kV HVDC transmission line from Kabul to Peshawar through Kasa project. The detailed comparison between these HVAC and HVDC transmission lines in Kasa project is beyond the scope of this lecture. They will be fully covered later on in the HVDC chapter in this course. Now I am going to discuss why transmission is required. The transmission is necessary due to the reason that it is not economical to generate the electrical power near the load consumption places. Now question may arise that why generation of power is not economical at load consumption places. The answer to this question is that generation is not economical at load consumption places due to the reason that site of the power station is dependent upon the type of the power station. The thermal power plants are constructed near the coal mines in order to save the higher cost of coal transportation. On the contrary, it will make generation expensive due to the high cost of coal transportation. The hydropower plant sites are governed by the availability of the water resources. The natural water resources are mostly available in hilly areas far from the public places. Therefore, it is not possible to generate power economically through hydro resources near the load centers. Moreover, the nuclear plants are also situated remote from the center of the consumption places due to safety reasons. Thus, the difficulty of getting power station sites near the consumption centers make it inevitable to transmit bulk amount of electrical energy through longer distances. Long distance bulk power transfer is only possible by high voltage transmission system. The power system may be of isolated nature as well as interconnected type. An isolated power system can be defined as a power system supplying power to a specific town, home or city and is not connected with any other power plant or transmission line is known as isolated power system. Figure shows the simple and most common example of an isolated power system consisting of solar panel supplying power to certain load. Another example of an isolated power system may also consist of any diesel generator supplying power to a hospital or a building. It may be noted that through isolated power system, electrical energy cannot be supplied to large community or to whole country. Therefore, mostly all over the world, including Pakistan, interconnected system is used. An interconnected power system can be defined as the connection of several generating stations in parallel is known as interconnected system. Figure shows the block diagram of an interconnected power system consisting of three generators interconnected with one another and supplying the power to the load. For interconnections, tie lines are used. A tie line is a transmission line connecting two or more generating stations with one another. It means that a transmission line performs two main functions. Number one, they transport energy from generating stations to bulk receiving stations. Number two, they interconnect two or more generating stations into a power pool. Now I am going to discuss how power system is interconnected. The power system consisting of two or more generating stations are interconnected through synchronization. For synchronization, following conditions are necessary to meet. Condition number one, voltage of all the generators must be same. If there are three generators as shown in the figure, then it means that for their synchronization, all these three voltages must be equal. Condition number two, frequency of all the generators must be same. Again, if there are three generators as shown in the figure, then it means that for their synchronization, frequency of all three generators must be equal. In Pakistan, 50 Hz frequency is used, whereas in other countries such as USA, 60 Hz frequency is employed. Condition number three, phase sequence of all the generators must be same. Now suppose if there are three generators as shown in the figure, then for their synchronization, their phase sequence must rotate in the same time in same direction as shown in the figure. Without fulfilling all these conditions, two or more than two AC power system cannot be interconnected with one another. Now I am going to discuss the advantages of interconnected power system. Number one, it enables the mutual transfer of energy from surplus zone to deficit zone economically. Number two, lesser overall installed capacity to meet the peak demand because power can be transferred from surplus zone to deficit zone. Number three, it permits the generation of energy at the most efficient and cheapest station at every time. Number four, the main advantage of an isolated power system is that if there is a major breakdown or scheduled maintenance of a generating unit in an interconnected power system, there is no interruption of power supply. Thus, interconnection provides the best use of power resources and ensures greater security of supply. Interconnection between networks is done either by HVAC links or HVDC or transmission lines. Now, I am going to define the electrical or power grid. A grid is an interconnected network for delivering electricity from producers to the consumers. The figure shows the basic diagram of a power grid. From the figure, it can be noticed that an electrical grid may consist of generating stations that produces electrical power, electrical substations for stepping electrical voltage up for transmission or down for distribution, high voltage transmission lines that carry power from distant sources to demand centers, distribution lines that connect individual customers. Thus, an electrical grid may also be defined as an interconnected power system covering a major portion of country's territory or state is called a grid. The different grids may be interconnected through transmission lines to form a regional grid. And when the different regional grids are interconnected, they form a national grid. A sample of national grid is shown in the figure connecting all power plants, transmission networks and distribution system with one another forming a national grid. That's all for today's lecture. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. If you like it, then don't forget to like my channel and subscribe it. Thank you very much.